This one-handed, and also try not to make you sick from it moving around. The problem is that we have these VEX wheels that are made to go with a VEX servo system for driving a robot, and the school has Futaba or Parallax standard servos, and you can see the VEX system is driven by a square hex key, and the Futaba servos are kind of what you'd expect, standard, and they have a round key system that just slips right into the servo. Sorry, I didn't have one of the servos unhooked to show you what it looks like. So I've seen some pretty ingenious things that they've tried to do. They did print out some kind of adapters that allow you to screw, use the square chuck and put it on here and screw the servo horn on there and hook it in. The problem with those is it made the robots about 3-4 inches wider than it should have been, and then during competition those things would run up against the walls or couldn't make some of the turns. It was just kind of clunky, and you could also see that it was kind of putting a lot of stress on the wheels, so the whole robot was bowing out because of the weight of the thing. So what we want to get to is a system like this where it can fit on there a little easier. So we got two problems to make that happen. Is one is the set screws. So here is the standard set screw. And when we put the, come on, let me do this one-handed. We put this on there. So we come up with about 2.5 is how round this is. And if you look on the internet, trying to find inch long screws is almost impossible for these things. They're, the spec I think says actually 2.6. So maybe my, measuring tool is off. And what we want to use is one of these screws, so we don't have to, so we can minimize the number of holes that we have to drill or how deep we have to do. So, and then the other problem we have to do is we have this flange here that it doesn't add a whole lot to it. Let's see, we'll measure it and find out how much that it adds to it. If I can do it one-handed here, come on, it's on the screw. I'm going to shoot this as one shot. I don't have time to edit this video. But, okay, so I'm going to try to measure it. And it comes out as... So... 0.013 of a millimeter. I'm not sure. Yeah, eyeballing it, that looks about right. Sorry. So we'll... do it to inches so you can see that. Oh no, I had it on inches. So it's 2.6 millimeters is how deep it is. Now that's not a big deal, but more importantly, the thing is that we want this to have a good mating surface up against it. And with this extra rim, so first of all, we wanna try to get this horn right up against these pieces. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use a lathe. And I'll try to show chucking it up with one hand. We're gonna try to remove this piece here and also carve out the center enough. I probably can't see it, but there's a little teeny, ridge right here. Now, I could shave that ridge off of the horn, but I don't want to. That ridge, if we shave out the center right, that ridge can really help us center the wheel on there when we're putting it on. And so then the third problem is, how do you get the horn to stick to this after we shave it down? Right now, I've just been experimenting. This one's drying right now, where I put super glue on both surfaces and I put it together and hope that they stick. I don't think that's gonna be good enough. Given the number that I have to do, I'm probably gonna get a can of body putty, lightweight Bondo, and super glue it so I know that it's at the right place and it's centered. And then I'm gonna undo the set screw, take it off, fill it in with Bondo, and let it dry. And what that will do is help hold the horn in place against the wheel rim for the transference of force. Because the set screw, all it does is hold the wheel onto the servo. It shouldn't have any forces applied to it other than that. When the servo spins, all the force should go from the servo through the gears to the horn and into the wheel and not have the screw. And if you don't do the screw and you do that, or if you just have the screw in without something to reinforce the horn to the wheel, when you go in reverse, it'll just unscrew the wheel. So let me back up a little bit too. So what I found was, well, let's talk about screws and then I'll get to the fun stuff. You probably just want to see the lathe working. So I was talking about these screws and we measured it and they were 2.5 millimeters about. The spec says 2.6. So now, like I said, nobody makes that screw. So what I was able to do is at Lowe's, and I'm sure Home Depot has it too. Lowe's just a little closer to where I was at the time. I could get these 1-inch number 4 wood screws. Now they're a little too, they're actually too big. They'll screw a little bit into the servo horn, but not all the way. Well, what I've been doing is I just chuck it in the lathe and I shave just a little bit off of those threads. And the way that it works in my Sureline is it actually, without doing too much, I can thin out or trim out these threads without anything special, just good old lathe work, and get it to the point where I can stick it through and only the last, you know, couple of threads are full size for the wood screw and the rest of them are slimmed out and they still catch and they still work, but you're not, I don't feel like I'm stressing the plastic inside of there, because I'm trying to do this pretty simply without causing a whole lot of damage to these pieces, and so I don't want to drill out the white horn, the horn gear in there, but I could if I had to. So I'm doing this on a lathe. I think it's important to know you could do this with some sandpaper or a file or a Dremel tool. Everything that I'm doing here, I'm just doing it on a lathe because I just want to have a good excuse to do something with my lathe. So I'm going to put the phone down while I chuck it up. I'm trying to do this without, you know, just quick and easy. So I'm not going to invert my chuck, which is probably what you're supposed to do. Instead, I'm going to just put it right over here and expand the chuck so that it'll hold it on the back side of it. So let me do that real quick. Okay, so I got it on there, and these are, well, that's an Allen wrench, but this is my Tommy bar, and I use that to help tighten the chuck up so that it will hold the wheel. And turn the lathe on, you can see it spin, and it looks pretty flat. So now I'm gonna do a pause here and kind of get my lathe set up a little bit better, so I'll show it cutting. Okay, since I'm doing these by myself, I'm trying to do it in two passes, where when I've worked with some of the kids, you know, we go over all the safety stuff, but we do it in like 6 or 7 passes, and we're just shaving a little bit off of it at a time. So I do one really at home here. I'm doing one big aggressive cut, and then I'm doing some smaller cuts. So I'm turning the wheel. And when I was working with the kids too, I tried to use it as a learning opportunity. I went over that this is each turn of the wheel is a tenth of an inch, and we measured how round that the piece is that we're cutting off, and it turned out to be, I think, 6 or 6.5 turns. And so we zeroed out the hand wheels, and they could actually do two things. They were counting the number of turns they were doing, and they were using their eyes to watch to see. Yeah, it's kind of hard to hold this thing still and turn the wheel. So I'm backing it out now, and I'm gonna go in for a final cut. And I apologize for the shakiness of it all. But I just want to get this up and out there, and I don't want to have to spend a lot of time doing a lot of video editing or anything, so sucks for you, but for the one person that watches this, but for me, it's kind of nice. So I'm going back and forth, and what I'm trying to do is make this flat. And just kind of testing with my finger. And feels pretty flat. Now, since I'm doing these in bulk, I am not, I'm just doing, making them flat first. And then I'm gonna go in and drill out that the center piece. And I think it worked out to about 1.5 turns. So if you get your, I'm actually gonna change the tool that I'm using to be one that angles, instead of angling to the right, it's gonna angle to the left, and then I'm gonna get it centered, and then I'm gonna pull out on it. And I think it's 1.5 turns is what we're doing, and it generates a hole that is really nicely centered. And I wish I had that piece so I could show you. Then you can put the horn on it, and that little bump, it just fits right in the horn. And then you put your washer on your screw. Oh, I should show that. I'll show what I'm doing with the screw right now on the lathe. All right, this way is probably a little bit dangerous in the sense that I could ruin my chuck a little bit, but what I'm doing is I've got my chuck, and I just want to show that I can wiggle it back and forth. I actually just bring the head right up against there. I'm gonna use the Tommy bars to chuck that in. It won't hold in here given the size and all the things, and I don't have a collet or the right size collets and tools to probably do it right. I thought about just getting a small piece of hose and putting the screw inside of a hose so then I could chuck it in and have it sticking out a little bit farther. But this actually, I'm able to pull this off, and it's my lathe, so I don't care if I ruin it. Let me pause it and chuck it up real tight, and then I'll show you me trimming it. Okay, the other day when we were doing this at the school, see if I can rest my hand right there and get it to focus. Okay, when we were doing this at the school, we did it with using the maths, where we figured out and we tried to get it aligned with the center and get things to happen. But I am just going to eyeball it here, and I'm gonna change the angle of my tool a little bit. Hold on. Okay, I'm just gonna, those of you who know lathes and stuff, you can see I don't have my gimbal set up correctly, but it's put away for a while, my lathe, but again, I'm not building an engine, so see if I can do this without killing myself here. When we were doing this, I didn't let the kids do this part at the school, but we ran, when we were doing the plastic part, we did the lathe really, really slow. I mean, you know, so if the wheel came loose and flew off, it wouldn't hurt anyone. But since I'm at home, I think I'm in probably like 1/3 speed right now. This is probably where it's making people nervous. I'm coming up against that tool, and I'm trying to hold the video camera. And I was using a different tool last time, so I could get a little bit closer. So I'm going to back that out, go to the hand wheels, and I am just going to turn this puppy just ever so slightly. And then go back in. Don't try to be too aggressive with this, because those brass screws will break right off. I don't know if you can see, little flecks of brass are coming off. Nope, there you go, I'm getting too close. I'm gonna back that off. Probably going too fast. Okay, come back here. Just a little bit more. Wow, 14 minutes, this video is way too long. Way too long. Probably pressing my luck here, but I'm going to do a little bit more. I said, probably the proper way to do this is put a little piece of hose around the whole screw so you can chuck that whole puppy in. And, well, I wouldn't say that's proper, but that's probably a quicker way getting the tool set that I have. I think that'll be good. We'll take a look. I'm going to take a little bit more off. You can hear him being a little bit more aggressive in my cut on this one. And like I said, it kind of works out to be the perfect length when you're screwing it in. Because you get a little bit of extra bite right on the end of it when it's getting screwed in. But this whole piece, you get bite on this farther down, but it's not too much. And here's what it looks like when it's done. So, of course, take that out, put the washer on it. I thought about tapping this in a little bit more, and then I could actually make that, get rid of that little bump, so then it would, it's even thinner, but, you know, I'm not trying to get, I think just getting rid of the half inch riser that was on there, or the inch riser off there is a good thing. But anyway, all said and done, it's kind of what it looks like. Sorry I'm not showing the cut where I take out the centers in there, but you can just imagine a hole about as big around as that piece right there, or that circle right there, and just right there, so it slips right in, locks it into center. Like I said, still working out the piece on permanently attaching this, but I think that's a fairly easy problem to solve. I was going to use JB Weld, but when I saw, and I still might do that, I still might just paint coat both sides with JB Weld and put it in. JB Weld, $7 for like 2 ounces, and Bondo is $10 for 32 ounces. So, not that I would going to use anywhere near all that, but there you have it. That's how I am fixing these wheels.